The Philippines' Interior Department reminds local government units they have the power to inspect business establishments as government clamps down on illegal offshore gaming operations in the country. Gracie Rutao reports.
These are just some of the videos allegedly showing incidents of torture and abuse happening in several Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGO hubs in the country. According to the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, most of the victims are foreigners.
Ang nangyayari kasi magpapadala ng torture videos itong mga sindikato. Pinadadala sa pamilya dahil ang pamilya yung pinagbabayad nila. So ngayon, yung pamilya humihingi ng tulong sa Chinese Embassy or Embassy Concern.
The PAOC says they are investigating the video that appears to have been recently recorded. The Department of Interior and local government is also moving quickly to help local chief executives and other relevant agencies to address the threats posed by illegal POGO operations. This meeting follows raids on illegal POGO hubs in Banbantarlac and Porac, Pampanga, including a sprawling leisure property allegedly used by POGO bosses.
Hindi na natin aantayin ang problema na mangyari pa. We will be proactive here. With all of the visitorial powers na sinabi na given to the mayors, given to each national and local agency, pagsasamahin ito para lamang i-mapping out ang mga illegal activities on the ground ng lugar. No, ganun ang mangyayari.
The DILG impressed upon LGUs and provincial agencies such as the Bureau of Fire Protection and the Departments of Environment and Labor that they have visitorial powers. The reminder comes after Porac Mayor Jaime Capil drew flak for failing to monitor illegal POGO operations.
Ating local civic executive ay may kapangyarihan mag-conduct ng inspection, hindi lamang po sa bago i-renew ang business permit application. Now, the POM period niya ay pwede yung i-conduct anytime within the year for purposes of determining whether there is compliance with existing national laws and the local ordinances of our local government.
Philippine National Police Chief Romel Marbil says no police officers were involved in illegal activities related to POGO operations. Marbil explains the dismissal of police chiefs and officers in Bamban and the provincial director of Pampanga was due to negligence.
We assure you, yung mga tao ko na natatanggal po, it's more of a productive, proactive act po natin. Ang sinasabi natin, it's more of their incompetence, not their involvement. But incompetence, bakit nagyayari po ito? Kaya po sila naririnig.
Meeting also emphasized close cooperation between government agencies and the PNP to eradicate illegal POGOs.
Lahat tutusan namin na talagang kailangan maging active na sila sa lahat. Hindi lang siyempre yung POGO, pati drugs, lahat, alungin na nila. Yung ordinansya na yon, gagawin namin ASAP, lalo na kung may mga foreigner kang investor.
In related developments, illegal water pumping facilities have been discovered at the raided offshore gaming hubs in Tarlac and Pampanga. The PAOC says the huge equipment were not connected to any local water districts. The POGO hubs, which host dozens of buildings and facilities, were found to be only paying a few thousand pesos a month.
Nung chinek nila, walang connection bot ang Bamban at ang Porac sa any water district. Kahit sa Angeles, dito sa Porac, o kaya sa Porac mismo, wala itong LS99, hindi nakakonect sa any water district. Nung nakita namin, puro pump pala, water pump ang ginagamit lang nila. Nakita namin malalaking mga tangke.
Mas magugulat tayo doon naman sa liit nung binabayaran nila pagdating doon sa water bill. Actually, ang binabayaran nila is nasa 1,000 hanggang 3,000 lang. Ano? Yung binabayaran nila monthly. Kung titignan mo, napakalayo doon sa napakalaking lugar nila na kasyang tumira ang 3,000 hanggang 5,000 tao. Tapos may Olympic-size swimming pool pa.
The National Water Resources Board and the Provincial Environment and Natural Resources say the POGO hub did not have the relevant permits to operate water pumping facilities. Local officials add the water pumps pose a risk to environment because over-extraction can create a sinkhole. Meantime, another economic manager also joined calls to ban POGOs. Budget Secretary Amina Pangandaman says the 40 billion to 50 billion pesos in government revenue brought in by POGOs is small. For the record, I don't think we need them. We gave a recommendation already, a joint recommendation from the economic managers, and I hope that they will consider.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has not publicly addressed the issue, with expectations for a possible announcement during his upcoming State of the Nation address. Gracie Ritao, ABS-CBN News.